All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Matt Halliday. He is the president and COO of Canada Silver Cobalt Works. And Matt, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Oh, it's great to see you again, Steve. I'm doing great. It's beautiful and sunny here.
Yeah, you're on site, right?
I am. I'm at the core shack in Coleman Township right now.
Nice stuff. Well, we've got a lot to talk about, so let's get to it. First off, the company has put out some news about applying for a recovery permit. And maybe you can kind of explain this, because there's been a change in legislation in Ontario that really fits into what this is all about.
That's correct. So basically, in Ontario, they filed a new bill, Bill 71, and it's a mining legislation. So in part of that, it's going to give the minister a lot more authority in making decisions. And one of the pieces of the new bill is that they're going to introduce the recovery permit. And that will get, basically, they'll develop a framework around that. It's not in force yet, but hopefully very soon. And the recovery permit itself is very interesting, because it is a permit instead of going through a full closure plan.
So this allows you to in essence, take what are leftover tailings and then use those in order to get recovery. Is that how it works?
Exactly. So basically, it's a streamlined process to be able to recover historic mine wastes. Not just tailings. It could include historic muck, waste piles, tailings, and the sort, maybe slimes. So, but it does provide an opportunity to be able to process that in a more efficient manner.
And you have a number of potential sites that you would like to do this on?
Yes, we do. Starting with the Beaver and also the Castle, we have projects that would be very beneficial for this type of framework.
Okay. And do you have sort of a time frame as to when this will all come down yet, or is it's with the ministry, so it usually takes a bit of time?
It's with the ministry, and it usually takes a bit of time. But if you go to the Ontario Mining Act, you can see that they have the framework already lined up. It's grayed out, so it's not in force. But, you know, they are making good strides. So, I mean, it's basically getting that framework up and ready and passed to go. So okay. I think it shouldn't take them too long.
All right. Well, we'll keep an eye on that one for sure. Very interesting. The other thing I want to ask you about is also that you had some news out talking about Castle East and that stripping has begun. So can you sort of talk us through that one?
Sure. So at the Castle East, we had a shallow intercept of 50 meters deep at 4,710 grams per ton silver. And nearby, we also had an intercept of about 24 and some grams per ton gold. And so we are planning to do a stripping program there. We actually have started the stripping program itself. We've flagged it out, and we've had some test pits, or not pits, but locations tested out. And so we're hoping to see if mineralization comes up to surface. And we also have some historic gold zone trenches and pits that were done in 2014 and 2015. And we'd like to open them up a little bit wider and see if we can take a channel basically across a larger area there to understand the Archean mineralization.
Matt, is this the busy time for you over the next months and to come? Is this going to be a lot of news flow coming from the company?
I hope so. It's a very busy time. You know, things are very interesting. We have a lot of projects on the go. So we're trying to get as much field work as we possibly can in while the weather is good.
Perfect. Makes a lot of sense. Matt, thanks for the update. Appreciate it. Very busy for you, and I appreciate your time.
All right. Thank you, Steve. Cheers.
All right. There's Matt Halliday, the COO and president of Canada Silver Cobalt Works.